Hey, it's Camilescu and welcome again to Mixers Insight. This time we'll talk about MasterSounds Radius 4, a popular product that has permanently become a staple in the canon of rotary mixers. First thing I want to say is a big thank you to the owner of the mixer for lending it especially for making an episode. This particular unit is from 2019 and probably comes from the first batch of Radius devices. Radius 4 is a 4-channel mixer with phono, line and microphone inputs. It allows you to send the signals to the effects loop and send the master output signals via record, booth and master outs. The unit is powered with 18V external power supply with an upgrade possibility I want to comment a bit later. So now let's see how it's all done here. First thing we see here is modular design. It splits the mixer blocks to many boards and in case of servicing, we have easy and fast access to every part. The mixer has modern technology touch. We can see SMD parts all around. It's again good news for technicians that will have to refresh the units later in the future. SMD parts are easier to replace, they save space, and thanks to very short leads, they minimize parasitic inductance of the connections. First impressions after opening the mixer are positive. Let's get into deeper details by analyzing every block of this device. When we look at board functions, the layout seems logical and simple. Following the logical way, let's start with the power supply. The power supply is, again, DC-DC converter. Don't be afraid of them, the legend of linear power supplies won't help you in 21st century. The heart of this power supply is a buck converter chip. The application of this chip in Radius mixer is smart and unusual. This single buck converter is used to produce both positive and negative voltage rails. It's called a split rail DC-DC converter and the magic happens thanks to a coupled inductor. The very last stage of the power supply is linear and it uses a very standard 78XX79XX family of regulators. The bigger regulators make plus minus 15V rails for analog part and the smaller regulators make 5V bipolar supplies for switching logic. I'm starting to sound like an alien, so let's talk about real world problems. Is the MasterSounds linear power supply upgrade worth it? Very important and interesting question. If you've done a proper A/B listening test and you can clearly pick up the winner, then you have an answer. From the science perspective, the claims of achieving the ultimate performance and finest fidelity of lower tones make a little less sense. Let's try to understand how a buck converter works. We feed the converter with DC input voltage. In this case, let's assume it's a super clean linear power supply from MasterSounds. Second essential thing is a PWM signal generator. It's a square wave with regulated duty cycle. The square wave closes and opens the transistor that acts as a switch that passes the current to LC filter. We can change the output voltage by changing the duty cycle. Thanks to this, we decide how long is the pulse that charges the LC filter. Longer pulse gave us higher output voltage. Sounds logical, right? So the super clean input voltage was used to generate the impulses that constantly charge the filter. Now let's observe the exaggerated scenario and plug in very messy power supply with 0.5V of ripple. It's a lot of ripple. The situation didn't change thanks to the nature of a buck converter. It accepts wide input voltage range while keeping the output voltage constant. And what about this dirty looking ripple on the output that can be seen on the right graph? By picking proper values, you can fix it with a good filter design. As you can see, by changing the capacitor value, the ripple got smaller. Proper filter is just one of the things that helps to achieve clean voltage rails. Buck converter chips, for example the one used in Radius, help to maintain good quality of the output voltage by using a negative feedback loop with an error amplifier. And let's not forget that internal power supply of Radius uses linear regulators on the very output and the power supply performance is strongly determined by this circuit. Using analogy, let's assume that MasterSounds linear power supply is a high-performance sports car with amazing engine, but it's being pulled by a nice SUV with just a good engine. The performance of this system is strongly limited by performance of a car that pulls the other car. If the SUV engine is good enough to pull the car in a stable way, then the performance of a towed car is negligible. For this reason, I think that linear upgrade is an overkill and stock power supply should do the work. If you disagree with this explanation, I'm open to discussion. We all can learn a lot from it. Now let's take a look at something much more simple. Mic preamp. Two channel boards have input connectors that let us plug the little boards with microphone preamplifiers. Thanks to one chip, the preamp implementation is super simple. The chip is 1510 from that corporation. It's a preamplifier with differential input. the signals from mic preamps go straight to the channel boards. There are two variants of these boards. One variant has mic input, the second variant includes booth or aux outputs. Taking a look at the rear panel can help you imagine how it's done. Every channel board has gold-plated RCA connectors for phono and line inputs. Let's take a look at Phono Preamp. It's a two-stage active-passive solution. This solution is rarely seen in other mixers, but this concept was used for example in classic Urey 1620. The idea is to split the gain to two stages and also treat one part of rear EQ using active circuit and second part using a passive filter. Splitting the gain can lead to lower distortion. This Phono Preamp also uses exotic op-amps I will show you in a second. Also the nice thing here are SMD film capacitors, quality parts. So what's so exotic about the op-amp? It's pretty uncommon and it's no longer made. It's dedicated for audio, but the producer remains silent what parameters make it special. It all hides behind the term Muses technology. Sounds esoteric. The most interesting thing on the channel board is a resonant high-pass filter. The most common implementations of such filters use VCA chips that allows us to change the resistance with applying a DC voltage. Unfortunately, VCAs produce distortion and color the sound. I mentioned before that Radius Mixer uses exotic op-amps and designers wanted to maintain their sound signature. It wouldn't make sense to raise the costs by using Muses op-amps and then ruin their sound with a colored VCA. I'm really impressed that mixer designer paid attention to such details. So the VCAs became replaced with passive potentiometers. Problem solved. The last thing in the channel strip circuit that is worth mentioning is that it uses passive volume control done with Alps Blue Velvet potentiometer. Two channel boards have microphone inputs that we've already seen. Now let's take a look at output section that is present on the other two boards. The implemented outputs are balanced and they use high quality differential line drivers from that corporation that let you convert the unbalanced signal to balanced one. The last thing on this board I didn't show you are cue buttons. Solid and nice is my only comment here. The signals from four channels get summed and the summing circuit is something above the standard. Master Summing Bus is fully balanced and this helps to improve its noise performance and offness of channel volume controls. In the summing circuit we can observe the esoteric Muses technology in all its glory. The summing amps use flagship Muses 01 chip that is very expensive for an op-amp. It's about 30 times more expensive than op-amps used in standard summing amps seen in other mixers. Advanced circuitry and layout. Under this term many speculations arise, but none are clarified by the manufacturer. The questions I want to ask in this context are: what makes summing good? What parameters of op-amp can give you better summing? And are we even able to describe good summing with technical language? The most popular term people use to describe good summing is the so-called glue. But glue is a sensation, it's far from describing what's really going on. I would really like to know your opinions about it. Now for me it's hard to say if using super expensive audio chips can improve the summing in the way DJs like it. Another important part of this board is isolator circuit. It's a 12 dB per octave three-band isolator. There is nothing outstanding here, however the use of high-quality film capacitors in SMD packages deserves praise. Aux return and insert and record out connectors are also here. Time to examine masterboard that is responsible for delivering the signal to master outputs and handle the headphone section. Let's check the headphone amplifier first. As we know from watching previous mixers, this circuit is often neglected by manufacturers. I didn't do a precise reverse engineering, but this headphone amp is probably a composite amplifier. The transistor pair works here in a common feedback loop with TL072 op-amp. Nice way to boost the drive capability of the op-amp and definitely better solution than driving the headphones from the op-amp alone. Sticking to high-end idea, I would place a bit better op-amp here. The headphone section also has switching logic that allows operation in split queue mode. Here we can see meter driver circuit with trim pots for calibration. And finally we came to the end of Radius 4 signal path. Master output uses the same balanced line drivers as booth and aux outputs. Many mixers use op-amps to balance the outputs. Those chips can be considered a more luxury solution. The output chips that are quite expensive are protected from external damage with transistors working as a diodes. It's useful when someone plugs your mixer to XLR input with plus 48 volt phantom power. Last thing I want to show you before measurements are view meters. Nothing to comment here, just watch how they look. Now let's measure THD and check if Radius is more on the colored or transparent side. It's the most transparent mixer I've measured so far in terms of total harmonic distortion. Quick check how it behaves in overload condition. Also super clean. So, it's true what they say about transparency of this device. To sum things up, I think that MasterSounds Radius 4 is a well-built mixer. It uses many well-thought-out solutions and does not compromise on costs in many parts of the circuit. It uses some esoteric audio chips that are much more expensive than standard op-amps, and care has been taken to preserve the sound quality of those chips. Balanced summing and two-stage phono preamp are also things that can offer better performance than competitors. It's a nice product for people looking for something different than the rest. It's all I have to say for now, and I'm looking forward to an interesting discussion in the comments section. And once again, thank you for the growing support. I'm glad that you find my videos useful.